So I just saw the announcement for Microsoft Loop, and that gets me super excited, even though when you initially look at it, the first thing that will go through your head is, hey, is this Notion? So it feels very close, but I don't fully agree with that. I want to dive into that. I also want to talk to about why this is good news for business in general, why it's bad news for Notion, and how they are going to fuck it up, because I know SharePoint and I've seen the worst. So let's have a look at it and dive deep. So what is Microsoft Loop? And it looks like a replacement for SharePoint, and that's not so bad because that's long overdue. I've been using SharePoint in a corporate setting to make inside information, to make documentation. It's horrible, doesn't matter if you use the classic or the modern version, you can make it work, but you're missing a lot of elements. And many a times I was thinking, like, if only I could use Notion here. But very often in large companies, it's not that easy. You have to go through IT.
Can I use Notion?
Computer says no.
First, it works together with everything beautifully. That's at least the idea if you look at the video. I don't fully agree. I've known and worked with Microsoft products for a long time, so I got a few pointers. And the first comparison that I saw on Twitter, and that's generally there, is, aren't they just stealing Notion's look? And I look at that and go, like, yes, at first glance you get that feeling, but then you start realizing that it's a bit like saying that Android phones steal iPhone's look or vice versa. There's a couple of elements that you just need in there and that dictate how a piece of software like this looks. So first of all, it's a block-based editor. You can look at other block-based editors like Coda, Notion itself, and WordPress, and they all have the same idea, at least if you use WordPress with a theme with block-based elements. And that is that there's something to click and drag the blocks around. It looks very blocky, that's the whole idea, because things have like a column and a wide, you can put things side to side. Things like that are, I mean, the bread and butter of a block-based editor. So that element's already there. And then we have the menu on the left with a tree-based structure in it. That's as old as time. Everybody has the menu on the left. The Explorer on your drive has the menu on the left. So it goes way back, and we could argue that Microsoft maybe even invented it. Well, probably somebody else they took it from. But it's everywhere. Like, Code has the menu on the left, Drive has menu on the left, Tascade has menu on the left, ClickUp has menus on the left, everybody has menus on the left. It's just where we as a user expect it. You don't have an option to put it on the right. That would just confuse us. And then we have on the top right, who is looking at the document, which is also like an industry standard. Google Drive has it on the top right. Notion has it on the top right. Microsoft already has it on the top right on all their other platforms, SharePoint, think Teams, Miro has it on the top right. So that's also like a common element that you just need to have. Then why does it look like Notion so much? Well, that's obvious. That's the cover and icon, because that's a staple of Notion, right? You have like the cover image and then the icon on the side. But even that is nothing new in this day and age. Lots of people set up their websites like that because it just looks nice. And the cover is arguably already part of SharePoint. It just looked horrible because there wasn't an icon. So it's just this flat line and then you get into text. And these days we know, like, pages, having them an icon immediately works because it shows on the page and it looks nice, and it shows on the sidebar and it looks nice. I mean, even in Obsidian, I'm now using emojis to make my file structure look nice. So these are things that are a given. They couldn't really work around it. They could have probably put the icon on the right to be different. If that's the only thing you're going to steal, you might as well go all the way. And this is bad news for Notion, because it was already hard enough for an external application that's cloud-based to get in any type of corporate atmosphere. Yes, you have users that just make an account and start building in it, but try and get approval from the higher-ups, and there's a lot of stuff that you hit. Issues that I've had with Notion, like, for example, in the city of Amsterdam, is that Notion doesn't store its data inside Europe, and that immediately means that it falls out of a couple of legislations, which I'll save you, but that means that you can't really use it for any sensitive data. And Microsoft have been playing this game, like, they're fully integrated in a lot of corporations they get, they pay for it, they have a data center that's close by, they follow all the regulations that are needed, because that's their bread and butter. They try to sell to large corporations. You could argue that when it comes to Office, giving it to end users is more of a, like a nice gesture on their side and to make sure that we're comfortable with their tools once we get into these big businesses. So this just makes it a lot harder for Notion to get into a company, because not before I had like a good argument, this will save us time and it will be better and stuff like that. But that argument is going to be swept straight off the table with something like Loop, because people that don't know Notion in depth will just look at Loop. They already looked at SharePoint, where it was a totally moot point and I could make a PowerPoint about it and explain why that wouldn't work. But with Loop, that, you know, like all the arguments get ticked away. So it's even harder to get Notion to be the officially recognized thing in big corporations. This is bad for Notion. But on the other hand, it's very good for people that have to work in business, because this is going to be the new default. This is going to be what's there already. So you get into a company, you need to store information. You want to do that in a block-based method like Notion. And as long as you can step over the fact that you're not putting it in Notion, but you're putting it in Loop, and the controls are a little bit different, but you get the same functionality. Yeah, I'm a happy camper. I mean, sure, it's too bad for Notion, but for me, as someone who works in a company and then just needs to get my information out, having a better tool set by default, instead of having to deal with either trying to get this through a sales infrastructure to get to that tool, or what usually happens, having to deal with SharePoint, which is absolutely dreadful compared to modern standards, it's a huge improvement. But it hinges on Loop being actually useful, because I've seen what Microsoft Teams has done to Slack. Teams is getting used left, right, and center, and then Slack gets sent out because, you know, Teams has chat as well. Chat in Teams is horrible. It's not comparable to Slack. Slack has spent a lot of time having like this social banter, chats, threads, emojis on. It's all things that bond the team together, and it's all small details that it's hard to explain in a PowerPoint why you should have Slack next to Teams. Because people go like, yeah, but Teams has chat, it's sitting in your company. And if that's what's going to happen, like we're going to get like a watered down version of Notion in the corporation and we have to work with, that's horrible. And that's also like my biggest worry here. But I'm also excited. Like I was looking at the video and I saw a couple of things of being like, that is something that we need. We saw the shared mouse pointer, which looks very much like Miro. And I hope that is actually in Loop and not just in the demo video. Because being able to see other people's mouse pointer doesn't sound like much until you're remote and you're both talking about the same page. Being able to see like, hey, look at this, and just put your mouse over it and see your colleague waving there makes it much easier to collaborate at a distance. And it's something that I think Notion should steal if they get the chance. But it's also very hard to pull off. Imagine right now when you're working in a Notion document together, you're typing something, and a bit later you can see it in the other document. And a bit, I'm talking like a fifth of a second or something. And that's not much, but it's good. But if you want to see moving mouse pointers, that means that you have to have like a live feed and then have to constantly update it. That's streaming tech. That's hard. Definitely if you have to do it at scale, like Notion would have to do. So I'm not sure if they can implement that quickly without it hitting like performance issues. And another thing that I liked when I was looking at the Loop demo that I'm missing in Notion is that if you look at the sidebar, you can see avatars to see where people are at. And this is again like collaboration tools. You can see that people are working in a document. And it also means that if a document is getting updated, you can see which coworker is working on that document. And that might trigger you to hop in there and provide some feedback because you were using the same documents and you were having questions. It's a collaboration tool that doesn't look like much until you have it in your hands. And I've seen it in other products where seeing where people are at. And I think the main example I would have for that is Discord. Discord has these voice chats and you can just hop into it and it just shows that there's someone in that room. That means that if I open Discord, I can see people chatting somewhere and I can think, hey, I want to join in this conversation. And now with Loop, and probably the integration with Teams, I can do the same. I can see that people are all in this document space working on something and then hop in there and provide feedback or ask, you know, what are you guys doing? Is this complicated? And that's the kind of remote work that we are looking for, definitely in this pandemic, post-pandemic time, where working remote will become much more the norm in large business. But I've also seen SharePoint, and there's a lot of things that get me worried when I'm looking at Loop. And the first thing is that it's trying to integrate everything. If you look in the video, you see PDF documents, Word documents, PowerPoints on the side. And I've seen that in SharePoint. It's tricky because you can't easily click through it. It has to load a huge application into your website to show you what you have had there. It's hard to search through. So like splitting up your documentation into Word documents, PowerPoints, Excel spreadsheets is not the same, even if you chuck them in the same bin, as having a one structured setup like Notion has. So that's like my main worry here, that the integration with all the tools that they have will make the tool complex, hard to find stuff, hard to edit because you need to open a large application. And meaning that a lot of people won't spend the time learning the tool and just chuck their documentation in there, not really helping the company forward, and just maybe even giving block-based things a bad name, just like SharePoint did. And getting these things working together is hard, no matter how many times you say together in your trailer video. When I look at the video, is that the build element looks nice, but it's not the same as Notion. I saw an image gallery, and if that's just images, then sure, that looks nice, but it's not the same as Notion's gallery view, because Notion's gallery view has like a complete database structure behind it. You can build things and combine things. And here it seems like you can mostly just chuck images together so that it looks nice on the page, and you can chuck documents together, which is something that I've seen in SharePoint, where they just make like an overview of the documents that are under it. That's also not the same as having like a gallery view, and that builds like a structure that you can click through. So yeah, I really need to see this thing in action to get like a final verdict, but those things I worry about as to making it useful for the end user. And I hope it's good, because if it's bad, people don't look beyond it, right? They'll look at Loop and they go like, oh, this was dreadful. And then they'll look at Notion and go like, that looks like the same. And they don't even try and won't know that Notion is like a cleaner or more flexible alternative. Then again, if Microsoft's version is really bad, there will be a lot of commotion, because people will be comparing this to Notion. That means that mainstream news will be talking about this. They will say like, hey, this new Loop was introduced. What does that mean for Notion? Notion will get a lot of press, and Notion is available, really big influx. And that's good for Notion, because people will put the bar somewhere. And then when Loop comes out, they'll need to cross that bar, else they'll just be called a weak Notion clone, which will probably rejoice the Notion community, but will still not help those people of us stuck in a corporate setting and having to work with Office 365 and Loop. I mean, the same thing is for Teams. I would love Teams that steal more from Slack, because I'll have to deal with Teams. I can't change that because I'm not part of the decision infrastructure there. So getting these features in there would be great. And it's the same for something like Loop. If Loop isn't as good as Notion, I much rather have Microsoft steal a couple of things, like a couple of ideas from Notion, so that overall I get better tools, and Microsoft improving their tool set because they feel the hot air of Notion breathing down their neck is good for all of us that have to work in corporations. So this was a super quick video, because I was excited about Loop and I really wanted to chat about it and give you some feedback. I'm planning to talk about it on a podcast soon. If that hits, there will be a link in the description, and I will put it out on my mailing list. Now remember, you're awesome. Keep it up, and see you in the next one.